What's up, everyone? So as a photographer, there are three important things in our career which are very important: money, time, and space. What if I tell you that we can save on all three together by just installing one single software? Wanna know how? Let's watch this. What's up, everyone? I welcome you all to my channel. It's Nitin Arora. I'm sure you guys must be wondering whatever I just said, if that's true. Frankly speaking, I myself thought it's a trap, or even if it's possible, I'm definitely going to lose my image quality and data because of the compression. But that's not the case, guys. You can trust me as I'm not lying. And I don't say anything randomly unless I test or review anything personally. So let me tell you what happened. A few days back, when I was chilling at my studio, I got an email stated if I have heard of this software called Rosy. And they also mentioned that Rosy is the first raw image compression software that preserves all the original image quality, including dynamic range, while reducing the file size up to 80%. Well, that caught my attention and I thought, why not to try my hands on it and see if I can really save my space, money, and the biggest thing for all, which is my time, guys. So in this video today, I am going to test this software on my camera images and see what Rosy does, how it performs, and how it can benefit all of us as photographers. But before doing that, let me tell you a little bit about this software. Also, I have a little surprise for you, so stay tuned till the end of the video. Now let's understand what is Rosy. Rosy has been built by a company named Dot Photon, which enables quantum-based raw image compression. Well, let's not get into physics and let's get onto the ground or field where we all belong to. In simple terms, it's a technology that can compress raw file data up to 80% without quality loss, drastically reducing storage requirements. For example, if you are using Canon EOS R6 and creates a raw file size of 30 to 32 MB, Rosy can convert the same into 9 to 10 MB, which I believe is going to be a game changer for all photographers, especially those who are in weddings and shoot thousands of images in a day. You know, I suggest everyone to click on raw images, as you get a higher bitrate, better dynamic range, and control over post-production. But the only drawback I always felt as a photographer, and I'm sure you would also feel the same, is the bigger file size, which takes up a lot of storage space, which means more hard drives, more cloud storage fees, and slower backups. And the whole workflow gets disturbed. It's always a good idea not to mess with the raw files. They are the digital negative after all, and once you delete image information from the file, there is no way to restore it. So, what are the options left if a photographer like us needs to save on space and doesn't want to compromise with loss of any information or image quality? Well, there are a few camera manufacturers that have also given an option in their high-end cameras by using a compressed RAW format, but you can do that before you click an image. There is one more software named Adobe DNG Converter, which is also a great option and reliable. It integrates nicely with Lightroom and Photo Mechanic both. And it's free as well, but the only con here is file size doesn't get reduced much. So the best option left is the Rosy, that optimizes and compresses any raw image file into a much smaller, much more lightweight DNG file. I believe most of the photographers here know the pros of using RAWs over JPEGs, but many photographers have never come across DNGs before. So let me tell you quickly what is DNG. DNG is a format that is developed by Adobe. DNG is a short form for digital negative image file in which the image data is uncompressed and kept in a lossless state. Adobe Lightroom, Photoshop, and all other major editing apps handles DNGs, allowing you to edit them non-destructively. But as we all know, everything comes with its pros and cons. And same way, Rosie also has a few limitations, which are: the first one is that it is a desktop-based application only and can't be used with tablets or smartphones. Second is it can only be benefited to Mac users, but you can sign on to the Windows waitlist by enrolling on their website. Third one is it does not support all camera models and the supported list can be seen on the website. So if you like this software, then either you have to get one of the supporting cameras or wait for some future updates to happen. The last one is, in addition to the type of camera, there are quite a few specific requirements for the files that Rosie can support. For example, if you are a Canon user, it won't support files with SRAW, MRAW. If you are a Nikon user, it won't support lossy compression, small RAW size, and Nikon compressed NEF extension. So these are the specific limitations that Rosie has. Okay guys, enough of introduction about Rosie. Now it's time that we should switch on the ignition and go for a test drive. So let's go. Let's see how to install Rosie. First of all, you need to download the free trial of this software, for which you have to go to its official website, which is www.rosie.co. Once you land on the website, you will have the option to try free on the homepage. Once you click on that button, there will be another page where you can see the supported cameras. And once you figure out your camera model on the list, scroll down and click on the Try Free tab once again. Copy your license key and download the software. Once the software is downloaded, install and open the same on your Mac. Also, it is suggested to download the Adobe DNG converter once you download Rosie. Though I don't know the real logic behind this, but that's what the experts suggest. And once you have both the software downloaded, it's time to see how does it work. Now open the software and you will realize that the interface and overall look is quite simple and easy to use. Rosie provides two options for optimizing and compressing RAW files. The first option is to optimize Lightroom catalog folders. This is the most common usage of Rosie for regular users of Lightroom. Files are automatically relinked in your Lightroom catalog, preserving all your existing edits and metadata. All original RAW files and the .lrcat are backed up to your chosen location. One tip that I would like to give you before compressing the Lightroom catalog: check if you tick in Lightroom automatically save your XMPs, or mark all photos and right click and save metadata. The second option is optimize individual RAW files. This option is mostly used by photographers who either don't use Lightroom or simply don't have to edit the images. Or they might also compress the files before they edit in Lightroom to have a smaller file size for faster workflow. By the way, that's what I do as well. Now let's do a real-time preview to see if it's truly lossless. Now I'll take this folder where I have about 100 of raw images coming straight from my camera, that is Canon EOS R5. Now either you can click on browse or drag the folder directly. As soon as I'll drag my folder, and you can see the images here. Now here you can also cross-check the total number of files and the space you will be saving approximately. Go to the tab and you can either save the subfolder in the original section or choose the folder manually. I will choose the first one, that is the original location, and all you need to do is to click on start. It just took us 2 minutes, guys, approximately, to convert all the images to DNG. Also, let's see how much space we have saved. Now to check this, I will go to original folder and compare the size of both, that is RAW and DNG. Here you will see Rosie automatically creates the folder for uncompressed files and your converted files will be seen here in DNG format. Now to compare the memory that we have saved, let's put the converted files in a folder and click on Get Info. So here lies the truth. The original RAW file folder was 4.5 GB approximately, which has now been converted to 1.8 GB, which means we have actually saved 3 times the space. I still can't believe it. But being a photographer, we have to go through one more check, which is to make sure that while the image size is reduced, there is no loss in image quality or color loss, as that's what matters the most to us. Let's import both the images, that is the CR3 and DNG file, to our Lightroom, and let's drag both images side by side for a better comparison. Though I can't see any differences in the images as of now, but let's try to zoom in the image to 200% and see if there is any noise or loss in the image quality. Can you believe it, guys? I can't spot any change or difference in the image, and it looks exactly the same. For my own satisfaction, I have also converted a file in Adobe DNG Converter as well to see whether it saves the same space as Rosy does. But what I realized is the file size was almost the same size as RAW, whereas Rosy reduced the file size to almost 3 times lesser. Now I'm gonna show you a few examples of RAW and DNG format side by side, and also a few of my edits which I did on both the formats, and you can see with your naked eyes that there is no difference at all, and the final output looks exactly the same. So after zooming the image, my confidence has also boosted to 200%, and I can suggest all my photographer friends and colleagues to try this software once and see the real magic happening in front of your eyes. Now coming on to the major deciding factor, which is pricing. Rosy offers 2 pricing options once you're done with the trial. The first option is for $79, in which you get a yearly subscription, and the second option is for $199, where you get a lifetime membership. There is also a surprise, which I mentioned in the beginning, that Rosy is offering a 10% discount to all my viewers if you use the referral code, which is given in the description below. As I mentioned before, I am interested primarily in the practical results and whether it fits my workflow. The files are drastically smaller, and even if there is any real drop in quality, I have been unable to spot it. And the file remains fully editable and compatible, so this box seems easily checked. And as far as the workflow is concerned, I believe, like me, most of the photographers use Lightroom these days. And since it can easily optimize with Lightroom catalog folders, so that completes my job. That's it, guys. I hope you find this video worthy and beneficial. And don't forget to use my referral code to get a 10% discount. Do like and share this video, and please subscribe to my channel. It's Nitin Arora. And do let me know in the comment section, what do you guys think about this software? Or you can also let me know if you have any confusion in mind. I'll surely revert to you guys. Now be safe and see you guys in the next video. We don't need all these drives now. Sell it off and get some money for me.